everyone, Erina here. I work alongside Chris at Magoosh, and while Chris is filming another video for your viewing pleasure, I'm here today to talk to you about the whiteboard for your GMAT online exam. If you're watching this video, it likely means you'll be taking your online GMAT sometime soon. Before we jump into any tips and tricks, I wanted to say that I am very proud of you. Studying can be difficult in and of itself, and studying during a pandemic makes that even more difficult. So by scheduling your exam and by studying as hard as you can, you're taking a huge step forward in accomplishing your goals, and I'm very proud of you. Okay, well, now we got all the mushy stuff out of the way, let's jump into the GMAT whiteboard tips and tricks. So unless you've been in a cryogenic nap for the last 3 months, you've probably heard of COVID-19, which shut down a lot of the in-person GMAT exams. Thankfully, GMAC, the test creator, was able to create a digital version of the exam, and originally GMAC only allowed for a digital whiteboard. Thankfully, they have recanted and reconsidered their stance to allow for physical whiteboards, so now test takers may use either the physical whiteboard, an online whiteboard, or a combination of the two on GMAT test day. So let's first get into the physical whiteboard. The physical whiteboard may only be 12 by 20 inches max or 30 by 50 centimeters for my friends who use a metric system. And the whiteboard itself may only have a white background. It may not have any grid pattern or anything else like it. And test takers are allowed 2 dry erase pens and 1 eraser. So I have an eraser at the end of one of my markers. You may not have any napkins or tissues, so if you don't have an eraser, I hope you plan on wearing a shirt you don't care about to erase your board. And those are the limitations for the physical whiteboard. Regarding the digital whiteboard that is provided for online GMAT test takers is a really basic set of features that you might expect from a basic image editing or creation program. It's got a pen tool, a shape creation tool, a text box, zooming in and out, redo, undo. But what's really important to know is that on test day, this whiteboard opens in a new window and it hovers and stays above your GMAT questions, but it does resize and it also does hold on to or save the equations that you may have typed in or any figures that you may have drawn. But it's also important to know that you may not use a touchscreen screen to draw in the whiteboard. You may only use your laptop trackpad or a wired mouse to get this to work. Okay, so we talked about the limitations of the digital and the physical whiteboards. Now let's get into some tips and tricks. Tip number one is to practice with the digital and physical whiteboard prior to test day. You want to be familiar with all of the limitations and the features of both of the tools prior to the exam. You definitely don't want to add on to a stressful situation by not knowing how to pan around the screen if you're using the digital whiteboard. I instinctively reach for my laptop's trackpad to zoom in and out, and I was disappointed to find that it didn't work and that I needed to spend more time practicing with the panning tool. So definitely practice during your practice exams or your practice lessons so that you feel comfortable using these tools and you don't have to feel stressed by learning how to use other tools during the exam. Tip number two, it seems obvious, but if you don't already have a physical whiteboard, please order it prior to your exam day. Definitely don't want to order one and not have one or be anxious about it arriving on time. I also really recommend purchasing more dry erase markers than you might need, just in case some of them arrive with low ink, or you end up utilizing your markers a lot while practicing and then go to take your exam and then don't have enough ink in them and you run out of ink during the middle of a question. So purchase your whiteboard in advance and maybe buy more markers than you think you might need. Tip number three, if you're using the digital and physical whiteboard in tandem with each other, I recommend utilizing the digital whiteboard to hold on to information that you need to carry on over throughout questions or sections, because it saves information, and then only utilizing the whiteboard for really quick calculations or information that you're willing to erase. Tip number four, if you don't want to mess around with panning and zooming in and out, we recommend clearing the whiteboard after each question. The downfall is that you won't have access to any previous work that you've created, but at the very least, you're not having to finagle with any of the features, and you're really just, you have a clean slate each time. All right, so those are our tips and tricks. I hope that what we compiled for you today is useful. If you found that this was helpful for you, please do like this video and subscribe to our channel if you haven't already. If there are any tips and tricks that are missing, please go ahead and feel free to comment them down below to help any other potential GMAT test takers. If you need help studying for the GMAT, Magoosh has a 20% off coupon. It's GMAT Whiteboard. I've included it in the description. And please let me know how you do on your exam. I'll be reading the comments, and I hope you're well. Thanks.